called Corey's Cabin. A man with two first names. They left him in the railroad yard when it took away the trains. And only one run a week comes on roaring down that line. So all he got to worry about is time. He sits in the brick house, his hands out to the fire, moving through his memories of love and desire. Telling me the stories of the glories of his past, but he always says the story of his Corey for the last. And he says my Corey's coming, I no more said story's coming, my midnight moonlight morning glory's coming on here, girl. And like I told you, when she holds you, she enfolds you in a world. I'd come by in the evening to find out where he'd been. He'd say, come on, sit down, kid, where shall I begin? And I'd say, you know my favorite, though you know I like the rest. But I love the way you tell me of your Corey the best. And so I'd hear his lifelong love recreated by his tongue. He'd turn back the years, she'd seem forever young. Though the other stories changed as they rolled through his head, he'd say the same words by Corey just before he went to bed. And then he'd send me away, and he'd be smiling as he said, can't you see my Corey's coming? I no more said story's coming. My midnight moonlight morning glory's coming on to you, girl. And like I told you, when she holds you, she enfolds you in her world. I was quite surprised to find out all the places that he knew. So I asked the townsfolk if his stories were true. Well, they said old John was born here, he's lived here all his life. Never had a woman, let alone a wife. And very soon you'll find out, as you check around, that no one named Corey's ever lived in this town. So I chided the old man about the truth that I had heard. Well, he smiled and said, reality, it's only just a word. Can't you see my Corey's coming? I no more said story's coming. A midnight moonlight morning glory's coming on to you, girl. And like I told you, it's when she holds you, she enfolds you in her world. I came by one evening, but it did not hear my shout. I looked in the window and I saw the fire was out. When he would not wake up, I forced in the door, and I found that old John Joseph would tell stories no more. There was the scene at the graveyard, just three of us were there. There was me and the grave digger, and we heard the parson swear. He said, we need not grieve for this man, for we know that God cares. They put the cold dirt over him and left me on my own. When at last I looked up, I saw I was not alone.
standing there in silence with a shawl around her head. Was a beautiful young woman, I remember what she said. Is that John Joseph there? I nodded my head, yes. That brought a soft smile from her. She said it's time he got some rest. So I said if you're a relative, he had a peaceful end. That's when she said my name is Corey. You can say I'm just a friend. Corey's coming. No more sad stories coming. A midnight moonlight morning glories coming, aren't you, girl? And like I told you, when she holds you, she enfolds you in her world.
Busted down old railroad yard, sure makes a lonely sight. You may wonder why a young man would work out here alone. Well, the job pays enough to keep some flesh on my